And good afternoon, Aaron. And those strong winds are still blowing here at Portsmouth. Now, we're told that they are awaiting the arrival of a computer part to get the plane airborne. That computer part still about 4 hours away. Now, for most of the Marines, this has just been another long delay in what has been a very long trip home. But for a fortunate few, they are already home.
The whipping winds didn't bother the Asenza family from Sandown as they hugged their son and brother.
That's awesome. I'm so glad he's home. I'm so glad. Even if we didn't get to see him, just knowing he was home, but it's even more special now that we've got to see him.
And in the back of the family van, a surprise for Lance Corporal Joe Asenza, his dog, which he brought in to greet fellow Marines.
It was awesome. I miss my dog a lot.
It's been rough, you know. Both my brothers have been gone. My other brother's in the service too, and I'm pretty much the only child at home now. So it's good to see him and be around him and hug him.
The plane carrying 300 Marines was on its way from Germany to California when it attempted to stop in Bangor, Maine, for fuel. High winds damaged the plane. The aircraft was diverted to Pease, where the winds weren't as bad. And like any passenger stranded at an airport, Marines passed the time as best they could. But some were lucky.
I hugged him.
For 8-year-old, soon to be 9, Gretchen Knowles of Rye, an early morning phone call led to a surprise visit with her uncle.
It's 5 in the morning. You know, give her a call, wake her up, get her out of bed, get the kid out of bed, you know. So what a great opportunity.
I jumped out of bed. I got her out of bed. Look at us.
Oh, yeah.
But see our T-shirts? There's Sam in Iraq.
Oh, yeah.
I'd do anything to get here.
Now, these Marines have just completed a 7-month tour of Iraq. Most of them are veterans on their second or third tour to a man. They all say that conditions over there are improving, and they also say that all those letters, all those packages from home do indeed help. Reporting live from Portsmouth, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.